jacket. You got to rock it the same way. Check it out. And then a Vester bag, which is a full moon circle. Oh man, this guy's ready. You love it. So first things first, let's talk about this grind. The grind, even though it might look like I'm going up on my tiptoes, honestly, that looks like I'm trying to mount a horse. We don't want that look. To avoid that look, you want to soften your knees.
Thanks.
So that your top dance height is lower than
standard.
So this is about as high as I go when I'm dancing. I just need to unlock my knees. And so when I do my grind, I'm not changing my height. I'm transferring all the work into my hips and knees. John's doing it backwards so that you can copy what he's doing. I'm starting with the right hand first, and it's as if I'm digging into my pocket for change or for my MetroCard. So the pocket's coming up to me instead of me and the pocket going up together. Yeah? So I'm going up. I'm letting that foot go a little bit to the side. And then transferring my weight. So as I go on to this, I lock onto that foot. Now, if you notice, you've got one pocket higher than the other. If not, fix it. Okay. Now, as I bring those feet back together again, the opposite one is gonna pop up and take a walk from there. It's important that the gravity applies when you want to look at all. So,
Okay.
But some people may not like to be DJ.
Yeah, I know. No problem.
Yes.
What?
If you want to look less like that person,
thanks.
Which we hope you want to look less like that person, you're not going to keep your weight in the middle. Let yourself move to each foot. Ah, feels different, doesn't it? Looks a whole lot better too. Nice.
Hello, hi, thanks.
So yeah. do you want to try with that along with music, or should we do the music?
Let's do both.
Alright. Mr. DJ, if you can play that same song.
So we'll start out with the mooch, then we'll go back into the ground.
I'll play this now.
Thanks, Paul.
This side first.
Put the grind into it. In 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and ha, 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 ha. Back to the mooching. 5, 5, 6, 7, and ha.
Work those fake jackets.
Back to the grind. 7 and.
Give your height low. Nice.
Excellent, thank you.
Thank you, DJ. Give yourselves a round, it's looking good. So dancers to the side and to the back, if you don't have an easy line of sight to us, there's still plenty of space up here in the front, so you can move up and share the space. Next step we've got are called swinging lowdowns. First, let's understand the weight change that happens inside of the swinging lowdown. In a swinging lowdown, for the most part, my head is gonna stay where my feet are together, but I'm gonna take one foot, take it out there. As far as you can go comfortably. Don't go, right foot yellow. No, it's not twisted. I take that foot out, and I bring it back in before I take the other foot out. We want a smooth transfer of weight. Boom, ba, boom, ba. Everybody, I feel like we're getting ready for 40 seconds. Now let's make it bluesy. Again with our soft knees. When I take that foot out, my hips are gonna swing like a pendulum towards that foot that I've swung out. All right, that pendulum is dangling from the top of my head over to my belt, so as I touch out, the hip swings with that foot. As this pendulum centers again, that's when my feet come together, and the pendulum swings the other way. So, you should hear the bells of Notre Dame while you're doing the step. Gong, 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 gong. You can add some hair, arms, something I'd like to debunk about blues dancing that maybe not all of you know. Blues dancing is not about bump and grind and about mom and dad are away, let's dance blues kind of attitudes. It's about swagger. As far as I like to think about it, it's about swagger. It's about confidence. When I feel confident about the way I move, about the way I feel about the song, I express it in what way feels strong for me. And if on your side of it, if you're looking at it going, that's on you. That's not on
me. Global.
You know what I mean? This is our perception.
Oh, yeah.
So think of it as giving yourself freedom to express.
Yeah, there's no one way to do this. You do what music makes you feel like doing. So if you want to be, if there's like a chill portion in the music, you have to chill.
Yeah.
If there's something exciting, then you like really go for it, right?
Just don't split your pants. And you know what, if it happens, smile, play it off, keep dancing.
Do what the music tells you to do.
Yep. Six, starting with your right foot, go out, 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 out. I'll mirror you. The skull is. Don't let this happen. Notice, you act. Now grind. Ha, ha, ha. Very sneaky. Now we try the march. Go. Back to the swing and low down. Go. Let it bomb. Show us with your dancing meter. Thumbs up. Awesome. What's the next move? Sideways.
Back to fish tails. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
Thumb meters, show me your dancing meter. How you doing? Good. Are you feeling groovy? Ooh, just wait. Don't worry. The groove will come as you find your song, as you find your space, get yourself in that zone. Let's move on to the next step. The next step. And what's happening is, the nice thing is, we have the advantage of having square tiles beneath our feet. If you start with your feet, don't bounce it out. Grind it out. Ready, go. Imagine you have a drink on your head. Don't spill it. Fish tail again. yourselves a round. Oh, this is so good. This is so awesome. Absolutely.
And?
So John's going to bring us home with our closing steps.
All right. Called Four Corners.
Uh-huh.
We're going to... It's kind of like the fishtail where you're swinging your butt around.
Okay.
But this time, you're...
So, we have the whole routine. When this song goes into its next phrase, we're going to take it from the top with the fly. Five, six, starting with the grind, go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, reach it out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, low down, swing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, push tail it out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, choo-choo, stop, power, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, four corners, 1, 2, 3, 4,
Beer.
Four corners. 1, 2, 3, 4. Mess around and grind it up. So good. You gotta give yourself pats on the shoulder. That was
it's
awesome.
The dance part.
That was awesome. Now, because of blues's fluidity in terms of there not being, for the most part, a set of rules about what a basic step is in blues or things like that. Salsa has a basic, tango has a basic, waltz has a basic. Blues, because of its very expansive history in terms of regional styles of music and tastes, we don't really have a general blues as always starting with this on this foot or whatever. People created the shapes, created trends, and from there it grew into its own world. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take the exact same steps in the same order, and we're going to stylize it to a song that the DJ is going to give us at random. So we're going to hear that song for a few seconds first. I want you to listen to it, feel what kind of groove it's got, and then when we count you in to do the same moves, feel whether you want to change it or not. Maybe you want to go bigger, or I don't know, what other things can they do to change their style?
You can make your movements smaller, you can make them bigger, you can go farther, you can go shorter.
Yep. So the DJ is going to play a random song for us. Let's listen to it first. Find that groove, find that feel, and we'll catch you later.
Ooh. Connect with that music first. Pulse. Feel it.
This is John Lee Hooker live in Detroit.
Feel it?
All right, let's do it.
1, 5, 6, 7, and 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
swing and low down.
It's
fast for me. I'm
Thank you.
I'm gonna bring her back.